Hello, everybody. It's Tasha, CEO and Chief Coach at Start Young Financial, founder of the Millennial Wealth Academy, and most importantly, my favorite thing ever, your sister in finance. And right now, I am in Fort Lauderdale, Florida at an amazing leadership retreat, and it is what? Right now, it's 1:19 in the morning. I just got done with a long day. I drove here overnight, went to leadership training, came back to the hotel, and I was all ready to go to bed. I have my night clothes on, and I was just like, you know what? That's not okay with me. I know that I need to get this information out, and I understand how urgent it is. We talked about in the last video how right now in America, 76% of people are living paycheck to paycheck, how 20% of people literally have less than nothing because they are so in debt, and that 70% of our population is at retirement age but not ready to retire, or rather 70% of the people at retirement age aren't even ready to retire. And so it really got me feeling the urgency of all of this. And I know that the last video came out a couple days ago. If you haven't done so already, take a second and watch that video. You can do so above. But I wanted to make sure that I got this, the sequel, to you guys in a timely manner so that it can make sense, so that it can be just a natural progression from the last thing that we talked about. So I'm here because I really believe in how important it is to set you guys up for financial freedom. My job is to make financial freedom easy and accessible. What I really want for you is to live a life that is full of happiness and joy. I want you to have financial joy in your life so that you don't have to worry about money. And the thing I want you to think about is, what would it look like if you didn't have to struggle? What would it look like for you to be able to do all of the things that you wanted? And I'm not talking about balling out of control. What I'm talking about is, you know, being able to enjoy your life today while also building for the future. That is what I want for you, and that's why I'm up at 1:21 in the morning doing this video, no makeup on, and, you know, this is what I'm committed to for you, and this is what I want to be. This is the contribution that I want to give to you guys today. So my goal is to, you know, do this quickly and effectively and efficiently so that I can get in the bed and so that you can get what you need. Today we're going to be talking about the financial automation blueprint. If you watched the previous video, we went into the four financial action areas, and you guys had an opportunity to download the financial automation blueprint. Now, the four financial action areas are the fourth step in the financial automation blueprint, but I wanted to give them to you first because they are the most important thing in helping you move your net worth forward in a positive direction. So to do a quick recap, now let's be clear, I really want you guys to go and watch that the first video first, but I know that a lot of us are pressed for time, so whether you're able to watch that video or not, I want you to have an understanding of the four financial action areas. So very quickly, the four financial action areas are as follows. Number one, you want to have an emergency fund that is 6 months of your expenses. And not only that, but you want to be able to start that as quickly as possible. So you want to have some quick start goals. Start with 100, move to 500, then get 1,000 as quickly as possible. And once you get $1,000, you can build slowly but surely from there. The second action area is a saving for the future. Saving for the future is a largely underrated component of building wealth. When you're saving for the things that you know are coming in your future, like a car, a house, a wedding, children, college. What that means is now you don't have to pull from your emergency fund, you don't have to pull from your investments, because you've already created a space with intention for the things that you want to create in your life. And that's why saving is so important, because now you are increasing your long-term wealth-building potential by not having to pull from other important financial areas. The third financial action areas is paying down high interest rate debt. Number two and number three are going to be interchangeable, and really none of this is a stair-step process. All of this is really going to be juggled, right? So you're not doing one or the other. You're figuring out what are your main priorities right now, and you're juggling them to the best of your ability. So number three is going to be paying down high interest rate debt, specifically credit cards. Eliminate that credit card debt as quickly as you can, because you don't want to pay to use other people's money. Number four is going to be invest for future growth, whether that is in your 401k, getting that that good old company match, or if it's going to be in your Roth IRA or a traditional IRA, something that you're doing on your own. You want to make sure that you are investing for your retirement, that you're investing for future growth. So those are the four financial action areas, and we're going to put that in context today with what I like to call the FAB system for financial domination. I want you to take over the world. I want you to be able to live a financial lifestyle that most people only dream about. And then I want you to take those dreams to everybody. I want everybody to be able to have a financial lifestyle that is free of stress and worry. I believe that financial freedom should be a right for everybody who is willing to work for it and not just a privilege for few. So the financial automation blueprint, or the FAB system for financial domination, is really a 7-step process. So hopefully you've had an opportunity to download the financial automation blueprint and you have it with you. And what I want to go over today is the 7 accounts that every young professional, and really every professional, should have. So we focused on the 4 financial action areas, and all of those action areas are going to be connected to a specific account. So this is what you call budgeting on purpose. This is what you call life-based budgeting. You don't just want to have a budget, but you want to bring that budget to life, making sure that your spending and your accounts are a reflection of the life that you want to create, and your budget is that cornerstone to make all of that happen. So really quickly, I'm going to go through the 7 accounts that everybody should have if they want to achieve financial domination. Number one, you want to have your main spending account. This is where all of the magic happens. Your main spending account is going to be where you have your check direct deposited. So you go to work, or you're working for yourself, and if you have a PayPal account, you're going to have that PayPal account channel your money into your main spending account, or you're going to have your job direct deposit your money into your main spending account. It's going to be like a checking account with the bank or whatever like that. So after you have your main spending account, and this is where all money in your financial ecosystem is coming through that main spending account, and your main spending account is now going to channel money to the appropriate places, okay? The next account that you want to have is a personal spending account. This is where all spending related to your day-to-day activities is going to happen. This is also what I like to call your swipe account. So if money is not in this account, you just can't do it. You don't do it. It's that simple. You allocate, you plan, you set the intention, and you create. And whatever you want to create in your life is mainly going to be done from your personal spending account. Really, what this is going to do is limit your spending to what you have already decided, to prevent you from pulling money from other areas of your finances. So that's what your personal spending account is for. This is for you. This is for your swipe money. And if the money isn't that in that account, then it doesn't happen. Number 3, your emergency fund. You want to have an account that's specifically dedicated and designated for emergencies. When something happens, you want to have money that you know is on hand and available to cover those emergencies. You do not want to have that money intermingled with other funds. All of your money should have a purpose. And when your money has a purpose and an intention, you're clear to create what you want. And what I love to tell people is that clarity leads to prosperity. So making sure that you're clear about the purpose of every single dollar that you have is only going to serve you in having a more fulfilled financial lifestyle. Number 3 is your emergency fund. Number 4, purposeful savings accounts. In this category, you're going to have multiple accounts. This is really a bucket account made up of multiple accounts. Your savings accounts are going to be for things like travel, You might want to save for a house. You might want to save for your education, for a personal investment. Whatever that is, that's going to happen under number 4, your purposeful savings accounts, okay? What are the things that you value that you want to save up for? That's going to go under the purposeful savings account category. Number 5, this is going to be your credit and debt accounts. These accounts include things like your credit cards and loans and car notes. Any type of credit or debt account is going to go under this category. So again, this is a bucket of accounts, and you want to make sure that you account for all of the debt that you have. Look at your credit report. You can go to annualcreditreport.com and pull your credit report, because you want to make sure that this is a comprehensive list of all the debt and credit that you have available, so that as you go and make a plan to attack it, that you don't leave anything out of the conversation. Number 6 is going to be your retirement accounts, mainly your 401k that you're investing, hopefully up to the company match, or your Roth IRA more likely, or if you have a traditional IRA, that's cool too. But that's going to be number 6. This is also going to include TSPs, 403Bs, or any type of retirement account that you have through your job or through a nonprofit or through the military or through the government, whatever the case may be. Wherever you have your retirement account, it's going to go under category 6. And you can have more than one retirement account, so this is also going to be a bucket account. And finally, number 7 is going to be your general investments. Okay, so this is going to be investments that you have in the stock market, in real estate, or in anything else that is not tied to a retirement account. That's going to go under category number 7. So those are all of the financial accounts that you should have, and this is all part of the financial automation blueprint. So yesterday we talked about the 4 financial action areas. All of those action areas should directly correspond to one of the 7 accounts that we talked about. In the financial automation blueprint system, you will find that we're operating in 3 different categories. Number 1, organization. Number 2, systemization. And number 3, automation. So if clarity leads to prosperity, the first thing we need to do is get clear about your financial actions, about your financial accounts, and about the results that you want to see. After we get that level of organization, we want to create a system. So right now, you have the blueprint. Hopefully, you have it next to you. And you also have some action steps to help you move forward. But what you're lacking is a fully integrated system to help you take your finances to the next level. And that's what we're going to be talking about in the next video. We're going to talk about how do you pull all of these pieces together so that you can create a financial system that works for your life, that works when you're sleeping, that works no matter what you are doing. So make sure that you are watching your inbox and that you get the next video in the system. It's going to be like mind-blowing. It's going to be so amazing. You're going to be like, man, why didn't I do this sooner? We're going to talk about how do you take the action areas, and how do you take these accounts, and how do you take the other steps in the financial automation blueprint and put them together to create a financial system that is going to allow you to live your life so that you don't have to worry about your finances, because you have a system that's working it out for you. And this system is going to allow you to build wealth. It's going to allow your savings accounts to grow, your investment accounts to grow, while your debt is beginning to decrease. So now you're going to have the experience of having more money, of having less debt, and feeling more financially free. And that's hopefully going to make you feel happy and excited. And what I want for you is to figure out, how do you do more of the things you love today while also building for the future? Because it is not okay with me that you sacrifice either one of those things. So that's what we're going to be talking about in a couple of days, you guys. I'm really excited about it. That's all I have for you. I am going to go and get my butt in the bed. But thank you so much for being with me and allowing me to deliver this presentation and this training. I'm so happy to be able to share this information with you. And I'm ecstatic about how we're going to put it together for next week. So with that being said, I'm signing off. Tasha, your sister in finance. Have a wonderful, wonderful rest of the day. Bye-bye.